Common data questions. Common data for questions 48 and 49. Two steel truss members AC and BC, each having cross section area of 100 mm square, are subjected to a horizontal force F as shown in the figure. All joints are hinged. The figure is given here. Question number 48. If F is equal to 1 kN, the magnitude of the vertical reaction force developed at the point B in kilonewtons is option A 0.63, option B 0.32, option C 1.26, option D 1.46. Question number 49. The maximum force F in kilonewton that can be applied at C such that the axial stress in any of the truss members does not exceed 100 MPa is option A 8.17, option B 11.15, option C 14.14, option D 22.30. Now, in the given figure, we can observe the joints A and B are hinged. Horizontal force F is acting at a point C, and the angle between the force and the rod AC is 45 degrees. And the angle between the force component and BC is 60 degrees. Now the solution is, let us say this point is O. Now in the triangle AOC, angle AOC is equal to 90 degrees and angle OCA is equal to 45 degrees. So angle OAC is equal to 180 minus 90 plus 45. Which is equal to 45 degrees. So this angle is 45 degrees. And now in triangle OBC, angle BCO, angle BOC is equal to 90 degrees and angle BCO is equal to 60 degrees. So angle OBC is equal to 180 minus 90 plus 60, which is equal to 30 degrees. So this angle is 30 degrees. We know the Lamy's theorem, that is when three forces, let us say FA and FB and FC, are acting at a point with an angles alpha, beta and gamma respectively, then we can write as FA by sine alpha is equal to FB by sine gamma is equal to FC by sine delta. Now let us apply this formula in the above problems. So in the above problem, let us say this is alpha, this is beta and this is gamma. Then alpha is equal to 90 plus 30, that is 120 degrees, and beta is equal to 90 plus 45, that is 135 degrees, and gamma is equal to 60 plus 45, that is 105 degrees. Now the question number 48. In the problem, it is given F is equal to 1 kilonewton. So if you compare with this diagram, if FC is equal to 1 kilonewton, then FB is the force in the truss AB. So FC is equal to 1 kilonewton, and we know gamma is equal to 105 degrees and beta is equal to 135 degrees. So let us apply the Lamy's theorem in this problem. That is, FC by sine gamma is equal to FB by sine beta. FC by sine gamma is equal to FB by sine beta. So 1 by sine 105 is equal to FB by sine 135 degrees. So FB is equal to sine 135 by sine 105. Which is equal to 0.732. But in the question, they have asked for the vertical reaction force. So vertical reaction force, let us say RB, we have to find. From the triangle OBC, we know the force component FB and we know F value and we know the theta as 30 degrees. So we have to find the force component in the truss OB. That is RB. So from the above diagram, cos theta is equal to RB by FB. So RB is equal to FB cos theta. So substitute the value of FB and theta. That is 0.73 into cos 30 degrees. So which is equal to 0.63. So the RB value is 0.63 kilonewtons. So the correct option for the question number 48 is option A, 0.63 kilonewtons. Now the question number 49. In the problem, it is given the maximum force F can be applied at C such that the axial stress in any of the truss members does not exceed 100 MPa. Let us apply the Lamy's theorem once again in this problem. That is, let us say this is FA and this is FB and this is FC and alpha is 120 degrees and beta is 135 degrees and gamma is 105 degrees. Now apply Lamy's theorem. That is, F by sine 105 is equal to FA by sine 120, that is equal to FB by sine 135. So FA is equal to F into sine 120 divided by sine 105, which is equal to 0.8965F, and FB is equal to F into sine 135 divided by sine 105, which is equal to 0.732F. So we can see FA is greater than FB. So the maximum axial stress can be applied in truss A. So stress in truss A is equal to FA by area of truss. That is equal to 100 MPa. That is given in the problem. But in the problem, it is given the area of truss A is equal to 100 millimeter square. So FA, that is 0.8965F, is equal to 100 into 100. So F is equal to 100 into 100 by 0.8965, which is equal to 11,154 newtons. That is equal to 11.15 kilonewtons. So the correct option is option B, 11.15 kilonewtons.